Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. Today I'll be discussing all the new flow enhancements that are coming along with Summer 22 release. The first enhancement that I'll be talking today is use of formulas as flow entry conditions. So let's go and explore that in a pre-release org. Here I am in a Summer 22 pre-release org. Let me go to the flow, and if I create a new flow, this has to be a record triggered flow. Let's say it's a flow on the account object. Every time my account is getting created or updated, and here in the condition there is an option called formula evaluates to true. I can choose this option. By choosing that, it will give me this, you know, window, this formula editor. And this is the new enhancement that is coming up with Summer 22 release. Now you have the option of writing your own formula to evaluate whether the flow should run or not. Remember, this is only available in the record triggered flow. And now basically what I can do, I can create is blank. I can use the function is blank, and let's say account mailing address. Account mailing address is blank or not. You have an option of check the syntax of your formula. So if you click here, it will say valid. That way you can start writing your formula in the entry condition. So let's talk about the next enhancement, and it's all about adding section headers in the flow screen. Now here I am in my flow section. So let me start creating a flow. It has to be a screen flow because we are dealing with the screen element. So let me start adding a screen element first. Let me give a name here. Let's give a main. Now what we can do, we can add different sections in the flow. So if you search section here, I can put my first section, and the enhancement that I'm talking here today, you can create your header. It's an optional, but if you check this checkbox, you have an option of putting a header title. Let's say this is my first header, I can choose another section, and another section will have another different header. The good thing is that the sections are by default collapsible. You have the option of making section multi-column. Like for the second header, I can put one more column here, so that way the second section is two column. Moving to the next enhancement, placing of name and address record fields directly in the flow screen. It is currently in a beta stage. Let's continue the previous example. In this first header, I can easily put the name input. By putting the name input, Salesforce would automatically detect that name is having first name and last name, so it will bring first name and last name together. The same thing here, let's get rid of the second column. In the second section, if I put the address is a new input. By putting the address here, it will bring all the information like the street, city, zip, state, province, and the country. Previously, it has to be a different input, but right now, after this Summer 22 release, Salesforce is bringing this two input, which is name and the address, which is by default give you, for example, the name, the first name, and last name. For the address, all the demographic information that comes with address. Let's move to the next enhancement. This enhancement is all about managing the run order of your record triggered flows from the flow triggered explorer. So here I am in my flow setup section. Here you'll find an option called flow triggered explorer. So once you click that, a new window will open. Here you can find out when an event happened, what are the operations that is happening in your org. For example, I can easily find out when my account is updated. When an account record is updated, what are the things that is happening in my org? Similarly, when a contact record is created, These are the operations that is happening when a contact record is updated. These are the orders, these are the actions that are happening in my org. The advantage now is that right from this screen, you can change the sequence of run. For example, here, when a contact is updated, on here, I can see I have this two flow that is running. One is like contact create update address, one is update account phone number. But this flow is running first, followed by this flow. Because of some business requirement, if I want my account phone number update should run first, I can control the run order right from this screen. What I need to do, I need to click on edit order and then drag this two to one and then click on update and another one more update. And what will happen is that my account phone number will run first, followed by my contact create update address. So this is a very powerful feature because now you can control the sequence of your flow. Salesforce is highly recommending to use Flow for your business requirement. So to me, this is a very powerful feature and you guys should go ahead and explore this feature. Moving into the next feature, it's all about accessing the flow trigger from the object manager. So here I am in the setup section. Now from the object manager, I can find out all the flows that were written for a particular object. So if I go to my object manager and let's say if I go to my contact object, right from the contact object, there is a section called flow triggers. Clicking on that, it will give me all the flows that were written for this particular object. Previously, before the summer 22 release, it was very difficult to find out all the flows that were written for a particular object. But after this 22 release, it's right from the object manager, you can find out all the flows. It's a very, you know, helpful feature for the admin. Moving to the next enhancement, you can write test scenarios for your flow. This feature is currently in a beta stage. So let's explore the feature in a pre-release org. So here I am in a pre-release org and this is a very simple flow. Though in reality, you might have a very complicated business flow, but the point is, you know, how to write a test for your flow. So let me first explain what this flow is currently doing. It's a record triggered flow on a contact object. And this flow is run every time a record is created or updated. And the condition to run this flow is like if the mobile phone number is changed for this contact, then only this flow will run. But once the flow is run, what the flow is going to do? Flow is going to, there is a checkbox in, it's a custom field on the contact object. The name of the custom field is phone changed. So it's going to mark that checkbox checked, or basically putting true value on the checkbox. Now to write test classes for this one, let me go ahead and save this one. The moment you do that, you'll find there is an option called view test beta. Clicking on that, it will tell there is no test class for you. So now you have option to write your first test. What you can do, you'll come to this page, you click on create. Let's give the name of this test. So let's give a positive test. This test will run every time a contact is updated. And with that, if we move to the next one, which is basically setting the initial triggering record. For that, I'm going to choose an existing record from the org, Jennifer. Now, if you see the Jennifer's mobile number is 1. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put the Jennifer's mobile number. I'm going to change the Jennifer's mobile number to something else. And then with that, I am asserting that the record is changed should be true. And I put, if it is not true, I am going to put a custom failure message, which is phone changed should be true. And then save. Once I save that, I'm going to click on this one again. And now I have a positive test. I'm going to click on this drop down and run test. It will run the test and it will tell that, okay, my flow is running perfectly fine. This is a very useful feature because right now, let's say I'm going to edit the flow. Let's say make it null, right? And save as. Somehow my flow is updated and I am supposed to put this, you know, checkbox true, but by mistake I put null. So now I have already my test written. So now if I run my test again, it will fail and the error message is phone change should be true. So this is a very useful feature, though it's in a beta stage, but this feature, I'm sure Salesforce will spend more time and enhance this feature. Currently, what I understood from the release note that this is not going to test something which is beyond the flow context. For example, your flow is getting triggered and flow is doing some invocable action, changing some record on a related object. You can't write a test from here to test those scenarios. Any operation happening beyond flow boundary, writing test scenarios here is not going to cover that. Okay, we have come to an end. I believe all these new features are going to help you doing your flow development. Please let me know your feedback and I hope this video is helpful. So please hit the like icon and share, and also please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, goodbye, take care.